Everybody say, hey ho!
Hey ho!
Welcome to KidVenture, you young buccaneers! We're glad you're here today because we've come to our new location on our quest for lost treasure. Last week on Easter, we arrived at a place called Jesus Jetty. Jesus Jetty is where we'll be finding out myths about Jesus and proving them wrong! That's what Mythbusters do! Everybody say, Mythbusters!
Mythbusters!
That's us! We're Mythbusters, proving myths about Jesus are wrong! Hey, Polly, what about you? I'm in the wrong outfit!
Oh, that's better. Much better.
Now, I'm ready for myth busting. I bet you're wondering why we need to prove these myths about Jesus aren't true. I'll tell you. It's not because it changes who Jesus really is. The real danger is that people, even other kids, might believe something untrue about Jesus. If they don't know the real Jesus, they might miss out in believing on the one true Son of God that came to save the world. Get it? Good. Let's take a look at the name Jesus, J-E-S-U-S. At Jesus Jetty, we'll have 5 lessons that will build off each letter of Jesus' name. When we turn a word on its side and build out the word from it, it's called an acrostic. Let's look at the acrostic of Jesus' name. Each week at Jesus Jetty, we set out to prove a different part of who Jesus is. Our first week, we solve the U in Jesus, which stands for ultimate solution. We learned that God's unstoppable love sent Jesus to earth to die and rise again to be the ultimate solution for our sin problem. But some people don't believe that. Some people believe the myths that Jesus really didn't die on the cross, or he really didn't come back to life. Wow. If Jesus didn't die for us, we'd still be stuck in our sin. And if he didn't rise again, he couldn't give us eternal life. So we're calling all you Mythbusters out there to come and help us disprove these untrue things about Jesus. If you're ready to help us do some myth busting, everybody say, count me in!
Count me in!
Oh, good job. Great. We're going to need your help because there are a lot of myths out there. I hear there's another myth on the street today. Man, they just won't let up. But don't worry. With all you Mythbusters on our team, we're sure to have no trouble busting this new myth just like we did the last one. The myth we're going to tackle today is connected to the J in Jesus' name. So be on the lookout for it. But for now, let's head into some praise time. So wake up, jump up, loosen up, and let's sing to the Lord. Isn't it fun to praise the Lord? Everybody say, let's praise him!
Let's praise him!
Bye, gang!
Red-handed Jill, and today we're going to be going over the motions of Pharaoh. All right, so a lot of you already know this, but for those who don't, the main part goes like this. Got to go Pharaoh, and then make a big O, baby. And then you got to do this, let my people go, and then go, huh! And then yeah. That's all you got to know.
And then there's this part where it talks about crocodiles, and you're going to get your best really wide crocodile hands, and when it says crocodiles, you're gonna go bam, 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 just like this. I knew you could do it. See you next time.
Well, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah. Pharaoh, my people go, yeah. We'll clap your hands and sway side to side as we sing this song with lots of pride. Hey, a burning bush told me just the other day that I should go over to Pharaoh and say, gotta get my people off this hot and dry sand and lead them all to the promised land. I say, Pharaoh, let my people go, huh. Yeah. Pharaoh, people go, huh, yeah, 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 yeah. Well, Pharaoh's army was coming after me, but the Lord God led us all to the Red Sea. We got across the water without a boat, but all of Pharaoh's army did the dead man's float. I say, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. We wandered in the wilderness for 40 years, and that's where we cried lots of tears. We asked Moses, give us something to drink. He hit the stick on the rock and our eyes did blink, because water came out. It was a miracle. We sang, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. So we went through the prophets and the Maccabees, and that's where we asked, oh God, please get us out of this exile, 'cause all these guys are acting like crocodiles. We said, Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go. Yeah, 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 yeah. Pharaoh, Pharaoh, oh baby, let my people go.
All you KidVenture kids, it's memory verse time. We started a new theme last week at Jesus Jetty. It comes from the book of Romans, and it talks about how Jesus can make us clean on the inside. Repeat after me. Romans 3:22.
Romans 3:22.
We are made right in God's sight.
We are made right in God's sight.
When we trust in Jesus Christ to take away our sins.
When we trust in Jesus Christ to take away our sins.
No matter who we are or what we have done.
No matter who we are or what we have done.
Okay, this time let's see if you can give the right word when I pause. I bet you'll be great at it. Romans 3:22. We are made
right
in God's
sight
when we trust in Jesus
Christ
to take away our
sins.
No matter who we
are
or what we have
done.
Great job, mateys. This has been Jeannie the Jumpin' Pirate. See you next time.
Hey everybody, we have a new song called So Good to Me, and so part of the song we just kind of clap, right? You've been so good to me. You came and found us and brought us into your family. And then there's this part that goes, you got me dancing. And now I'm shouting, and then we cheer, yeah! And now I'm leaping, and now I'm spinning, hallelujah. That's one part, and then it goes, we're telling God he's so good for sending Jesus. It goes, you're so good to me. And then we go, nah, 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 you're so good to me. Nah, 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 you're so good to me. Nah, 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 you're so good to me. Like that. Okay, let's try it. It's gonna be fun. Get up, get into it. Let's celebrate it.
Oh God, you've been so good to me. Found this orphan and you brought me right into your family. Oh God, you've been so good to me. You threw away my past and you never count my sins against me. You got me dancing.
Yeah!
You got me leaping, and now I'm spinning, hallelujah.
wake up, I breathe another breath of your mercy. Oh God, you've been so good to me. My delight is in you, cause I know that your hand is upon me.
Mythbusters, I'm Agent Janice, Mythbuster Investigator for KidVenture. Agent Ed, who you just saw, was right this month. We will be exploring myths about Jesus and proving them wrong. Yes! So awesome! Some people are missing out on the incredible treasure of knowing the real Jesus because they believe myths about him instead of the truth. That's terrible, and we can help. Okay, are you ready to hear the new myth? If you are, let's hear the secret Mythbuster snap. And the room gets really quiet during it. Can you hear it? Shh. Okay. I think our Mythbusters are ready. Let's take a look. Today's myth, Jesus wasn't really human. This myth says that Jesus looked like a human, talked like a human, moved like a human, acted like a human, but he really wasn't a human. These people talk about his miracles, and they say that no human could do those things. They say, I can't heal the blind or make a lame man walk, so if Jesus can do those things, he must not have been human. Today we are setting out to prove the first letter in Jesus' name, which was a J. He was just like me. He was human, just like you and me. To fight this myth, we have to dig up some proof that Jesus was really a living, breathing human being, just like us. And to help me this week, I've deputized some new Mythbuster investigators. I've sent them out to dig up some proof that Jesus really was human. Let's see what they've come up with. Let's call in Mythbuster number one and see if they've come up with any proof. Everybody say, Mythbuster number one.
Mythbuster number one.
So, Mythbuster number one, did you dig up any clues that Jesus really was human?
I sure did. Our first clue for today comes from the Christmas story in Luke chapter 2.
Okay, great. Let's take a look at Luke 2, 6 through 7. Go ahead and read it.
You bet. Jesus registered with Mary. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for Mary to have a baby. So she gave birth to her first son. Because there's no rooms at the inn, she wrapped the baby with pieces of cloth and laid him in a box where animals fed.
Wow. Did you know what that means? We have proof that Jesus had human parents and was born as a baby. That's the way you and I were born too, and we're human, so that's good proof. Thanks, Mythbuster number one. Well done. Let's call in Mythbuster number two, see if they've come up with any proof that Jesus was human. Everybody say, Mythbuster number two.
Mythbuster number two.
So, Mythbuster number two, did you come up with any proof that Jesus was human?
You bet I did. Our second clue today comes from the story of the Last Supper in John chapter 6.
Great. Let's take a look at Mark 14. Would you read it for us, please?
Sure. It says, the teacher asks, where is the guest room where I can eat the Passover meal with my disciples? In the evening, Jesus arrived with the 12. They were at the table eating.
You guys might remember this story. Just before Jesus was arrested in the garden, he had a special meal with his disciples called the Last Supper. I'm sure you remember hearing about that. Did you see what it said there at the end? And they were at the table eating. The disciples ate and Jesus ate. Do you see what this means? Jesus ate food. He had a body like us. We eat food. That's a good proof that Jesus was human. Thanks, Miss Buster number two. Good job. Now let's call in Mythbuster number three and see if they've come up with any proof that Jesus was human. Hey, Mythbuster number three, have you come up with anything for us?
Yes, I did. Our third clue today comes from a stormy story in Mark chapter 4.
So, Mythbuster number three, would you read that for us? Would you read Mark 4, 35 to 38?
Okay, here's what it says. Jesus said to his disciples, let's cross to the other side of the lake. He was already in the boat, so they started out. But soon a fierce storm arose. High waves began to break into the boat until it was nearly full of water. Jesus was sleeping at the back of the boat with his head on a cushion.
This story is kind of funny. Jesus is so tired from teaching all day and doing miracles that he gets in the boat and falls fast asleep. The disciples are so frantic that they wake him up and say, don't you care that we're going to drown? Jesus jumps up, calms the storm, and the wind just stops and the big waves smooth out. Mythbuster, you may have made a mistake. I don't see proof that Jesus was human from that story. Do you guys see the proof? Oh, he got tired, just like us, and needed to sleep. Of course. Good job, Mythbuster number three. I almost missed that one. Okay, it's time for us to call in Mythbuster number four now to see what he's come up with. Hey, Mythbuster number four, have you come up with any proof that Jesus was a human just like us?
Absolutely. Our fourth clue comes from the story when Jesus' friend Lazarus died from John chapter 11.
Okay, let's take a look at John 11, 32 to 35. Please read it for us, Mythbuster.
Will do. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled. Where have you laid him? He asked. Come and see, Lord, they replied. Jesus wept.
Oh, I see. This was Jesus' friend, and he was sad that he died. This is our proof. When Jesus was sad, he cried, just like we do. If our friend died, we would cry too. I get it. Nicely done, Mythbuster number four. That was number four. There's one more big one. I wonder if anyone can guess what it is. We talked about this a bit last week. Does this picture give you a clue?
It happened when Jesus went to the cross. Any guesses? Jesus could bleed and he could die. And he did, just like us. Jesus has a heart and there's blood running through his body. And just like us, if we lose too much blood, we die. That's exactly what happened to Jesus. So we have five proofs now that Jesus was really human. Let's review. Do you remember what they were? He had human parents and was born as a baby, just like us. He ate food and had a body, just like us. Jesus got tired and needed to sleep, just like us. When he was sad, he cried, just like us. And lastly, he was able to bleed and die, just like us. So what's the big deal? Why did Jesus have to be human anyway? Hebrews 2:14 tells us exactly why. It says this, because God's children are human beings made of flesh and blood, Jesus also became flesh and blood by being born in human form. For only as a human being could he die, and only by dying could he break the power of the devil who had the power of death. Look at this picture. See, we had our sin, and that sin deserved judgment. That verse tells us that because Jesus was human, he could take our sin and give us his holiness. That means perfection and the absence of sin. That's what holiness is. Then he could pay the judgment for our sins and give us his blessing instead. This is really cool stuff. Hebrews 4:14 through 16 says, Jesus is able to understand our weaknesses. When he lived on earth, he was tempted in every way that we are, but he did not sin. Let us then feel very sure that we can come before God's throne where we can receive mercy and grace to help us when we need it. That just means that Jesus knows exactly what we are going through down here on earth. He knows how we feel and how hard things get for us sometimes. But because he is now in heaven, he is ready to help us when we call out to him in prayer. So today's myth that Jesus wasn't human has been successfully debunked. That means proved wrong. We were able to prove it by using the Bible, which tells us that Jesus was born, ate food, got tired, cried, and could bleed and die. Because he was human, he could take our sin and our punishment, and give us his holiness and blessing, including helping us in our time of need. It's so wonderful. Great job, Mythbusters. Let's pray. Thank you, Father, for today's important proofs, right from the Bible, that Jesus really did live on earth as a human being, just like us, and proofs that he is our Savior, who completely understands us. And thank you that we can trust him to be with us always and help us get through our hard times and the hard things we have to go through. What a wonderful friend you are, Jesus. We love you. Amen. It's been great being with you. See you next time, Mythbusters.
Remember, the Zoom chat is a little earlier at 10:45.